Hello and Namaste everyone, you're watching Smarty Tech Face and I'm Anjali with a new video related to the HTTP SSL handshake. So we have already covered the first part where we have understand how does it actually works behind the scene, that is how the HTTP SSL handshaking work and how the client and server just respond it back when two-way SSL handshaking is required. And we have understand what are the prerequisite we required before we will start working on this, and how our project will handle all these requests, and how we will proceed with the request to make us we will proceed with the server request where the SSL handshaking is enabled. So this is the prerequisite. We have understood all the things in the first part. Now in this is the second part, and today we will understand that how we will make a curl request to the server, as we have already understood this diagram and how the request and response has been received in these things when SSL handshaking is enabled. We have already understand that, but today we will make a curl request. Now today we will actually start with working with this and how the our application will start working with the SSL handshaking. So before working with the application, it must be required that you should try first with the curl request. So how you will make a curl request to the server where the certificates are required, where the SSL handshaking is required. So let's get started. Before this, if you are not aware of all these things what I am going to do in this part, please firstly go with the first part and watch this so that you will be aware what are the certificates we require, what are the files we have created, all the things I have already explained in the first video. So it is required to please watch the first part, then only just come to the second part. Okay, so in the last part we have understood this, that we have a certificates. We have three certificates. First is the first one, we have a root certificate. We have then we have a primary certificate that is containing the domain, your domain certificate. Then we have a DigiCert certificate. And next, what we have done in the last part is we have created a pen file using our private key. So why the private key required? As I have told you earlier, that when the private key is sent in the request, it will try, the server will try to decrypt the certificate at their end. If that matches, then it will enable the request and will provide you the response with particular format whatever they want. So we have created the PAM file. So how you will create a PAM file, I will just repeat it again. What you have to do for the PAM file, you have these three certificates and then you have a private key. So you have to merge all the certificate and the private key in this format, like begin RSA private key and your private key, then end RSA private key. Then you will start with the certificate of the primary certificate. Primary certificate will be your domain certificate. Then you will come with the DigiCert CA certificate, this one, the intermediate certificate. Then you will add with the root certificate. So this is how my certificate look like and provided with the name of .pem. So you can see that this is the RSA private key. I have added this. Then I have a primary certificate, then DigiCert, then the root. Okay, so this is how you will create your PEM file. Then using your PEM file, you now have to make a curl request. Now I will move to the curl request and you will see that how we will use this file. Okay, let's say this is my domain, this is my server request with some this is a post request with some URL and then header and then payload. Let's say this is the server API which I want to hit and want to get back the response. I just want the response back. But here what is the catch is the server has been enabled with the SSL handshaking. So until or unless I'll not provide my keys with the private key, my private key with the other certificates, then it will not allow me to get the response. So you can see that here I have only provided the payload and the API. If I will just hit it, so what is it is giving me the error is SSL error system call error, because it is not providing me the it at the server end, it is not able to decrypt their decrypt the like keys using, it could not find any private key and it is not able to decrypt any certificate at their end that they have hosted at their LBs. And what they have hosted? They have hosted R means a client certificate at their end, and they will try to match with the private key that we will provide with the file. Now, as I have told you that I have made the prime already, I have created the PEM key, PEM file. Now I will use the PEM file. I will provide the certificate using this parameter. This is --cert. This is a certificate path, and here I will provide the path of my certificate. The path of the certificate is this, and this is the key file. This is the PEM file which I have created now. Now, using this PEM file, which is creating my cert, which is containing my certificate and a private key, when it will hit the server, what will it do? The server will now see, okay, it is containing a private key, it is containing a certificate. Now let's match with the certificate which I have at my end. Now decrypt the things, and now it will match our request, match our file, and it will be able to do whatever they want to do. And if the key file matches, then after then it will provide me the response back. Now see, I have just provided the PEM file. Now if I will enter, it will give me the response back, and this is the response what I wanted. Now I can work on this response. So this is how you can make a curl request when you have enabled the HTTP SSL handshake at the server level, at the server end, and if you want to hit a curl request. So this is all about the HTTP SSL handshake curl request. We will talk about the postman request, and how you can make a request through the postman when SSL handshaking is enabled in the next part. So till then, take care. Bye bye.